that may not stop a bullet.
And tonight we have details of an independent test done on the same make, model, and lot number of a vest that failed a Phoenix police officer back in November. CBS 5's Donna Rossi has been following the story. And Donna, the results caught some people off guard.
Yeah, you know, I don't think they expected things to turn out exactly the way they did. It's one thing that back in November, a bullet went through the very bottom edge of an officer's vest. That's an area that manufacturers and national standards warn may be vulnerable. But it's something completely different when, in a controlled setting, a bullet blasts right through the center of a vest that is designed and marketed to save lives.
It's not a call a mother wants to get at 1 o'clock in the morning.
But it's a call that Lynn Daly got in November, telling her her police officer's son had been shot on duty, and the bullet pierced his body armor.
When I heard it officially at the hospital that it went through the vest, I was very disturbed at that point.
Officer Tony Daly and his parents were at the news conference today when it was announced that a vest just like his failed miserably in an independent safety test.
There was one complete penetration of the vest, and that projectile was not recovered.
The test was done out of state yesterday. Police, union, and city leaders wasted no time taking action.
That officers that chose to purchase a particular vest can immediately get a different vest, one that the plea has more confidence in, and they will be appropriately reimbursed.
And we're going to make it right. One of the things that we do not compromise on is officer safety.
Officer Daly hopes to return to work in another month. He did not feel comfortable commenting on the test results, but his mom said when she learned the news, her heart went into her stomach.
My son was in the hospital for 15 days recuperating, and I'm just thankful he's alive.
The vests in question were made by Custom Armor Technologies. Now, that company is no longer in business. Bottom line, Phoenix wants their officers out of these vests, and the city is willing to pay to assure their safety. See?
Donna, thank you. This is potentially a deadly situation for officers, and we wanted to find out what other police agencies here in the Valley could be using these vests. CBS 5 reporter Jadion Thompson has been doing some digging and joins us live with what she found out throughout the day. Jadion?
Well, Steve, we've contacted over a dozen police agencies across the Valley to try to find out if there are other officers wearing these vests that could potentially be in danger. So we kind of broke it down for you in terms of a couple of different videos. I want to get to that and show you. Basically, we have Scottsdale, Mesa, and the Chandler Police Departments all saying that they can confirm that their officers do not use these vests, that along with the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office. Now, a group of other departments we checked would say they do not believe that their officers are in the vest. If you'd like a better idea of who those agencies are, just take a look at your screen right now to take a look at that. And we also want to let you know that we had contacted a couple of other groups. We've reached out to Maricopa, Goodyear, Gilbert, Peoria. We're waiting on some responses from them. Now, of all of these groups, the Department of Public Safety is actually the one that could confirm they do have officers wearing these vests. They even told us that they learned of the news after getting phone calls about it today from us, the media.
We have 56 officers that currently have that manufactured body armor vest. That leaves us ultimately 56 families that could be affected by a defective vest, and that really does concern us a lot.
Now, DPS also went on to say that because they're just learning of the news, they are going to look at the investigation that we were talking about earlier that was done by Phoenix Police and then decide if they need to follow suit and take some of their own action, like possibly replacing these vests that those 56 officers he was talking about could be wearing. But that could take some time.
Jumping on, after looking into this, it's our understanding that these protective vests are supposed to be approved through the National Institute of Justice. So why wasn't this one recalled?
That's a very good question. We've been trying to get in touch with them today to ask that scene, and honestly, we've been playing a little bit of phone tag, and we haven't been able to get them on the phone and to have that conversation yet. Something and an answer that we definitely want to bring you as soon as we get it. We're also told that it's Diamondback Tactical, who used to be the supplier of the vest. It used to be a Valley company. They've since moved on. We've been in talks with them, but also haven't got an official soundbite or statement from them. Something else we're also trying to work and get for you later on in the 6:30 newscast, so I encourage you to stay tuned for that. Reporting live in Phoenix, Jadion Thompson, Channel 5 News.
Thanks, Jadion. CBS 5 News was first to tell you about problems with these vests. Some law enforcement officers have to pay for these vests themselves out of a special fund set aside for them. Others pay a portion of the cost. It all adds up to a lot of money to replace these defective vests. And we are partnering with Cox and the 100 Club.